Here's a short demo of some of the Safeguard Remote Access capabilities. So I'm already logged in to the service, remote-access.cloud.180.com/connections. And we'll see here that we have the connection points, or cards, if you will, that are presented to the users. So these are the published access points. So we have two categories, one for RDP, one for SSH. You do have options to filter down on protocols, by policies, etc. In this example, I'm going to select this mem5 im.corp server and log in as the domain administrator account. Now, this is assuming that I already checked out the admin account from a vaulting technology, such as Safeguard, privileged passwords. I'm going to hit click connect. And momentarily, we'll be connected via the Safeguard session appliance and be prompted for the authentication. So there we go. Again, supply the password. And we'll be logged in here momentarily. Again, this is just using the end user's browser of choice. And we're logged in. Another example would be the SSH connection types. So again, down below, I'm going to select the CentOS 7-138 server, log in as root. Again, assuming I know what the password is, click connect. Be prompted for the password here momentarily. Supply the password. Run a few commands. And we're logged in. Oops. LL. If I jump into the actual Safeguard appliance itself, quick little refresh, we're going to see the two connections types. Now, again, on the left-hand side, selected active connections. This is showing me the two connections that I've just been established, one for RDP, one for SSH. Again, you'll see the remote users logged in as administrators, root, coming in from remote access, or starting platform, source IP, destination server side. And again, you do have the option to follow or terminate the connections if necessary. If I go to the search menu option, again, we're going to see some of the active connections. I can also drill down to each one of these connection points. The overview just gives us a high-level configuration of the IP address, time, etc. Some of the analytics scores behind the scenes, whether the login was unusual or not. We can go to details, shows a little more granular information about the actual connection down to the channels, what we're accepting, denying, etc. Timelines, again, right now we're still active. So what we could do is terminate the session, and I'll come back over here and I'll do a quick little exit. Again, wait a few seconds, and we'll do a little refresh. And you'll see now the commands were just executed inside that session itself. So we have the who am I, the L, my typo, LL, and exit. You can select each one of these timelines. It'll show a screenshot on the right-hand side of the actual command itself. You can also look at the analytics of the session. So again, we give you a summary, highlights some of the patterns, whether they fit the normal behavior for the user or not. We can see the frequent item set, gives us multiple points as to, you know, the connection, time of day, the length of the session, the protocol being used for that user, whether it fits within his or her normal patterns. Host login, some of the commands that were executed. Again, we can see my little typo, L, it's unusual. Some of the normal ones are the login time and keystrokes. Being that I wasn't in there very long, there was no baseline actually found. You do have the option to replay the videos. So again, I'll click play video. We can see the commands being executed during that session. And that concludes the demonstration of Safeguard Remote Access.